Hello, dearest viewers. Welcome to Erimu TV, the station where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi, taking you through chemistry, Form 2. Stay tuned throughout the lesson and do pay attention. So what are the goals of this lesson? Previously, we have introduced ourselves to halogen, and we know the members of halogen, that is the likes of fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. So in this lesson, we are going to look at the following objectives. How do halogens react with metals? We'll also be able to describe how halogens react with water. And also, we are going to state some of the uses of halogens. So, reactivity of halogens. As we go down the group, the size of the atom increases because there are more electron shells. That is, there is an increase in the number of occupied energy levels. So the outermost energy level electron gets further away from the positive nucleus. So when an electron is added to the halogen, it is less attracted to the positive nucleus. So also there is more shielding of inner shells. So again, the electron is less attracted to the nucleus, and so the halogen becomes less reactive. So fluorine is the most reactive member of halogen, followed by chlorine. Then we go to bromine and iodine, and the rest follows down the group. So it is also important to now that will help us now understand how they react with the fluorine. Number one, reaction of halogens with water. All halogens react with water to form two acids, acid 1 and acid 2. For instance, water reacts with chlorine to give us hydrochloric acid and hypochlorous acid, also referred to as chloric 1 acid. From the chemical equation that we have here, we have HCl, which is hydrochloric acid, and hypochlorous acid, which contains an active oxygen. And it is also important to understand that the product for this is what we refer to as chlorine water. And hypochlorous acid, since it contains active oxygen, it is not stable. So when exposed to sunlight, chlorine water, a gas is liberated. The gas liberated, therefore, is oxygen, but not chlorine. So don't confuse between the two. And the equation for the reaction, therefore, is 2HOCl in aqueous state, expose it to sunlight. This gives us HCl plus oxygen gas. So what does this tell us? The concentration of the acidity of chlorine water increases, since it is converted from hypochlorous acid to chlorine acid, which is more concentrated. So how do they react with metals? From the setup that we have here, we have an aspirator through where a chlorine gas is bubbled through sulfuric acid. Basically, it is to dry the gas. Then it is passed through a combustion tube which contains iron wire. And from the other side, you can see the product formed is iron 3 chloride. From the knowledge that we have looked at previously, we understand that it is sublimes. And therefore, we have calcium oxide, which is basically used as the drying agent to ensure that moisture does not get through to iron 3 chloride. So, in general, a halogen plus a metal gives us a halide salt. So in this case, we have chlorine plus iron, so it gives us iron 3 chloride. Don't forget, iron has two valences, iron 2 and iron 3, but in this case, the stable iron is formed, which is the higher oxidation number, which is iron 3 iron 3 chloride. So chlorine gas plus iron gives us iron 3 chloride. You can see it is brown in color. If we use bromine, it will react with iron again to give us iron 3 bromide. And if we use iodine, it gives us iron 2 iodide, and you can see the physical properties of the salts formed in that case. So how do other metals react with halogens? An alkali metal will react with the halogen to form a metal halide. Sodium plus chlorine, gives us sodium chloride, and etc. So what are some of the uses of halogens? As you can see, fluorine is used in the manufacture of toothpaste, and therefore it helps to prevent tooth decay. We also have iodine. It is required by the body to prevent iodine deficiency, hence added in small amount to the table salt. You can see we have iodized salt. That is, it contains iodine. We also have chlorine and iodine. Chlorine and bromine are added in water to treat. It is used in water treatment, especially in river pool, that is swimming pools, as well as sewage treatment. You can see that these halogens have got various harmful effects. For instance, chlorine leads to chlorosis in plants. There is skin inflammation and damage of the eyes, and it also leads to corrosion on corrosion on sceneries, cast sceneries and metals, and therefore destroying their attractive nature. So they also have got their side effects. So let's look at the following test. State and explain the observation made when chlorine gas is bubbled through a solution of potassium iodide. Basically, this is a reduction reaction looking at the reactivity of halogens. Question number two, write a balanced chemical equation for the reaction that occurs in the reaction above and state the reason why reactions liberating a halogen should be performed in a fume chamber. Give one application of a halogen. For more, you can refer to Secondary Chemistry Student Book 2, or you can give us a text through the number on your screen. Visit our YouTube or Facebook page at Erimu TV, or give us a tweet at @ErimuTV_KE. Once again, your tutor, Mr. Mangi Francis. Stay tuned for more lessons.